get that. I want to bring this up. Okay, so the timer's going. Oh, an advert's playing on my site, but that means that for those who are rude enough to use Adblock, this is going.
What's going?
The stream.
Okay. Hello, person.
Oh! Hello. Oh. You came without a noise on my side. Yeah, just a heads up, I am streaming now. Playing Spyro again, because... God damn it, Spyro is a good game. Okay, that's all 400 gems. I can go back to this place now because there's nothing else for me. I'm not sure if that's a sad or happy ending for this world.
Let's see. Apparently rock people don't like the music.
Yeah, they prefer rock.
Oh, I know that guy kind of likes it.
I think he's just gone insane though. Like, the look on his face is... Oh god, I'm breaking.
But it's a case of... No, this music isn't actually too bad. That one... You have just seen in the building of an army. They are going to entrance all of the rock people to do their bidding.
Honestly, with the way this game's been going, I won't be surprised. Oh shit! Well, as far as dark openings go.
Sort of in
goatee people. Oh, the humor in this game.
Wow.
You see what I mean?
He tried to warn him.
You tried.
didn't get too fast.
The best part is that afterwards the guy's like, I'll move up, I'll budge up a bit.
I think the best bit of that is like, oh well, he's dead.
Yeah.
Good job.
Yeah, I just like that. Oh, that's amazing. Wait.
Hey, buddy, watch out! There's something that's going to crush you! Yeah, whatever. But! Well, try to warn him. Never mind.
Oh.
Wait, it's more rock people.
Yeah. So apparently the rock people are doing a nationwide attack. Oh, you almost killed me.
You know what that means to me?
What?
What this means is that this is the aftermath of what you just did. Those centaur people are invading this land using the rock people as an army.
Oh my god.
Oh. They are attacking their shorter brethren by the looks of things. Their shorter blue brethren. Hmm?
My cat was meowing at me.
Okay.
My fucking chocolate, piss off.
Where am I going again? Oh yeah, there's ladders over here somewhere, isn't there? I just completely
if
got...
If you don't get chocolate.
I got turned around completely then.
It's been a lot of quiet today, haven't had anyone talking.
I'm not surprised really, it's Monday. So right. Basically everyone's at school.
It's Bank Holiday Monday.
Ah, good point.
Also true.
Then again, if it's a bank holiday, parents are like, oh, we must do something together today. I sense that you've been through this, Sarah.
I'm a waitress.
Take
the long-suffering sigh of someone who tried to close the cafe 3 times and every time some fucker came in before I could close it.
Pull out a shotgun. The cafe is closed!
And then while I was running the last meals out, but we weren't getting any more food, and I'm walking past people who are trying to sit down and going, we can't serve food anymore. We turned away about 5 tables in the end.
Yeah.
There's a issue in Undertown at the moment.
What's going on in Undertown?
Someone's opened a Furby shop.
Oh dear.
I'm sorry, the Furby shop, what the fuck?
Also, I just noticed something, Steve.
Nothing but fucking Furbies. I'm horrified.
What
at the moment in the stream for me, you're basically hopping around on a giant dick. A giant wasp dick.
Okay.
Okay, there's actually more than one giant wasp dick.
Awesome. Gravebot's resurrected itself. Good lord.
Oh, you went. When you said okay, you went right back to the one of the giant rock dicks.
Oh my!
You've just seen it, haven't you?
No. I just saw something far more dangerous.
Oh, the auger. Oh, no, not auger drill. Wow.
This is probably one of the most sickening levels I've played.
Thinking back to sort of what these things would actually mean, that was absolutely brutal.
Yeah.
To check if... is that door?
Oh.
I mean, if in any other sort of situation you sort of suggest the idea, oh, I'm going to drill his brain down with a pneumatic hammer. Well, if it isn't my people would look at you funny. Spyro the Kids game in 1999? We're going to drill his brain out with a pneumatic hammer. Great idea!
I'm just going to vaguely point at Crash Bandicoot.
But made by the same people at the same time period, so...
No, Spyro's Insomniac and...
Oh yeah,
Crash is not the actual.
Yeah, they're in the same studio though, if I remember a lot of the points. Which is why there's a lot of cross-referencing between their games.
Well, they were both tied to Sony, so that's probably the more reason.
Like, that's why... If you play Jack and Daxter, why there's references to Ratchet and Clank in it, despite the fact that they were also made by, I think, Insomniac and Naughty Dog. Because they were both in the same studio at the time.
Okay. Probably owned something owned by Sony.
Yeah.
Wait, there's floaty shooty things. See them or have seen them?
Don't know, but
I assume you saw like jets of steam and lava.
Oh,
there was shooty things. So
thanks for closing the lid on the book.
I'm curious.
What?
Wait. I'm assuming you're going at the volcano's lid.
This makes no sense.
About that you had to close the lid on the volcano. The erupting volcano.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to come up here because why not? This looks like a nice place.
Yes, close the lid on the volcano.
Good realistic.
That will make things all better. Wouldn't like pressure's going to build up and then explode and flatten this entire area. Especially considering that volcano appears to be in the middle of a volcano. Your volcano is in the middle of a volcano.
Yo, Dogger, how do you like volcano? What the fuck am I meant to do? Oh, I know what I'm meant to do here.
You're meant to grab the pretty thing from just above the lava and kill them.
Yeah, I'm just gonna go around and get rid of all the part of the balloons first.
Yeah. I really wanna play Crash Bandicoot, but I kinda wanna stream it, but I can't stream it.
No, which is sad. I will say though, Stephen, we did have a viewer earlier today, but it was a silent viewer.
Oh, I didn't even know.
And they left.
If I'd known, I would have, baked a pie.
Yeah.
I baked a cake just for you. That's what I meant to say.
Baked a cake just for you.
Eat a bit.
I baked a cake.
You caked the bake?
I caked the bake! I also baked the cake.
The cake was absolutely baked. Looks like you're doing pretty good on the run that's showing at the moment.
Well, I haven't died yet, so...
Massive
improvement there. I keep missing this one down here because... I never have a rock when I come by it. At least these guys don't
respawn. I suppose it's always good to have something to have one which you know the location of. Which if it's the last one, you can just go, okay, I'll deal with you last.
Yeah, but I always lie when I say I'll deal with them last. I kill them last.
That's because you're Arnold. Looks like you're nearly done. Three.
Let's see this. Nope, didn't eat that.
What? Really?
Meow.
Exactly.
Damn it.
One.
Did you go
under me? Oh wow, I just saw just how behind I am. I was.
There we go. Do me wait with the cheese, but. I'm not questioning it.
What?
Apparently the orb got mixed in with the cheese balls. Okay, I've got...
Yeah, sure. Why do they want cheese in a volcano? It'll just melt. Unless they're making sort of... not cheese toasties or something.
Just go around here and... check for...
I'll be right back.
Okay.
Is it? You're making my life very difficult right now.
Okay, 70 gems left. So as long as there's no more money bags in this mission, I should be... Okay. I should be good from gems at least. So if they're all in there, I'm going to be annoyed, but... Okay, let's... Okay, apparently that's not the right way to do that. Screw it, I'll go get one of those. There's something I'm meant to do here, but I keep buggering it up. Unless I'm somehow meant to get the flying power up all the way up here. That would be quite an insane feat. Pull that off. What the heck is with this background music for this game?
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
And I've just found out there's been, quite recently, another shooting in America.
Another one.
Well, as long as they're not shooting at me, that's one nice thing, I guess. Okay, let's see, where else? If this is what I have to do, this is insane. No, because I'm locked to here. So that's not what I do. I guess I could ride a lift up, but... But yeah, somehow I'm missing two orbs, but I have no idea where the hell they would even be. Yeah, they actually removed the power up, so I can't bring flight up here. So unless I have to do an extreme glide from... Yeah, that certainly wasn't it. Try getting to that pot, but I can't reach it.
Interesting.
Because I mean, I've got two orbs and 70 gems unaccounted for, which is a hell of a lot. Is that higher? It's closer. This might be the better place to do it. Nope. And this isn't... Oh, wait, it is! So, it's just one of those really, really difficult ones.
Yeah, the difficult jumps are annoying.
Okay, so how many have I got left? 47. So now I've got to figure out where in this level they're hiding 47 gems. Oh. Oh, never mind. I thought I'd found something, but no. I think this is one of those levels where I never actually completed the whole thing. Hold on. Yeah, I thought so.
I've just tapped over to the Furbies R Us place in Undertown, and the conversation has just gone, what the heck is this place? Horror itself. Thought so. Nothing else.
Good.
The horror.
It's Hunter. Well, I've got 400 gems and I'm willing to believe that he's the guy who gives me the last two orbs.
Hey, Spyro, check out this quite probably.
Every so often, a little piece of this crystal popcorn pulls out of the ground. First one to grab 10 of them wins. Oh. What the? Why can't I get any? There we go.
You're catching up the air. Yeah, thought so.
Damn it. The funniest ones is when you catch them out of Hunter's grasp. Okay. Here's an orb. Why not just give me the orbs, Hunter? You know I need them.
I'll give you another orb.
Yeah, you can't steal him off of Hunter in this version.
I missed what this round is first two. What's this round, the first two?
The first one was first to 10, this one's first to 15.
Oh, okay.
But in the second one, he'll catch him on the way up as well as on the way down, so you can't exactly steal off of him anymore. Damn it. Jeez, he gets ahead of you very fast.
Yeah, the AI can be somewhat cruel at times.
I think this was before Rubber Band AI, wasn't it?
Rubber Band AI?
Basically where the AI will get easier or harder depending on how far ahead or behind you are.
I'm not sure. I think that's mainly in racing games.
No, there's a lot of games where rubber band difficulty's in.
I don't know of any, but then again, it's not something that's usually easy to prove. Except in something like a racing game where you can actually see them go whether they're going faster or slower. I know Crash Team Racing had the rubber band difficulty.
Yes, a lot of games now that don't have a general difficulty option, or an obvious one, will have rubber band AI on it instead. I think to a very extreme degree you could... Actually, no, that's not rubber band at all, actually, come to think of it.
What?
I was going to say to a very extreme degree, maybe Binding of Isaac, but...
No.
That's too random.
Yeah. And it's seed... And the levels are seed-based anyway, so... And the AI is pretty consistent in that. In that... Though its aim might not be consistent, it doesn't waste its time trying to get you.
Oh, for fuck! I can't get past like 13. It doesn't help that Hunter
plus,
also knows where
the
crystals are.
The creator refused to put in an easy mode, instead added a harder mode. I would say that with, in the case of Edmund, the AI is what you get. There is no easier thing for it. It is simply is.
Damn it.
It's possibly better not charging enough bit of a time in this. Well, at least not charge jumping. That seems to do you out a few times. I mean, not that charging doesn't make sense.
Oh, fuck's sake! God.
Interesting that this is basically popcorn to them.
They say crystal popcorn. So it's probably just that to them it acts the same way as popcorn does.
Maybe.
I have to wonder what these crystals are made of though. This is one of the most relentless minigames I think I've played in a long time.
Fair enough. Would you say that if this was just a game, it's one of the most relentless games you've played?
Yeah, but if this was just a game, they would have spent a lot more time on the AI to make it relent. God damn it! Basically, whenever Hunter gets to 14,
Bartos is probably more relentless.
Yeah, whenever you get to 14, he gets to 14. You have to chase him, else you instantly lose. But the problem is, his AI.
You can't always guarantee.
Yeah, his AI. He can make it so he can catch it before.
You can really.
Yeah, before you can.
Unless you're standing where it's going to pop up.
I might actually do that, hold on. Okay, I was better off doing my... Yeah, I've already lost this one though, look how far behind I am.
Just do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams!
This isn't my dream anyway! This crazy guy just won't give me the items to save the world!
I realised I didn't push the talk. I didn't push the talk a second ago because I said just do it.
Yep. Oh, thank God. Yeah, give me this frickin' orb, Hunter. Shut up your ass later with the other 42 I've got. Okay, where am I going?
Then you must come up with some harder games, Stephen. So Hunter is... I think Hunter's trying to work against you.
Well, to be fair, Hunter said he'd get all of it first, but... that means we should be working together, not against each other like this. It's also in, this, in the
Unless
third
Hunter
game...
Is a double agent.
Yeah, in the third game as well, Hunter... Rivhold's dragon eggs from you, saying you have to do skateboarding challenges, doesn't he?
No. In terms of that, he always says, "Hey, look, while we're doing that, I also came across this dragon egg." So he isn't necessarily going against you, but that might just be lies.
Yeah, also considering the fact that how the frick did he pick up a dragon egg while he was skateboarding and not, no one noticed it.
Scoop it up as while he's going along. Tuck it into his
exactly. unless he's got like a scrotal like pouch, which he's popped everything into.
Will explain why he's also hiding these orbs. At least we don't have to think about that world too much anymore.
Holy shit! This game's getting even more brutal! How can this be possible?
Oh god!
Okay. Oh god. There's only one more level and then there's... And then it's Gulp, if I remember. Shady Oasis.
I mean, if you suggested some of these concepts, I'm pretty sure you would get a rated 18 game.
Yeah.
Using a pneumatic hammer to drill out someone's brain. I'm pretty sure that's probably you're talking on Manhunt levels there. Pushing someone into lava. These guys.
Sarah.
Yeah.
Hungry hippo.
There was the freaking egg thief to here with apples. Shorty the Hippo. Richard, I swear. Sarah. You're better than him. Don't do this.
You really think that was better than me?
You have a lot of respect.
Oh, my sweet summer child.
I will stop the stream right now and kick you out of the car.
I'm so proud of myself.
Richard, do you seriously want to die?
You want to know what I keep doing?
What?
I keep hearing me and Sarah go, nee.
So you're answering it.
you're basically answering the stream whenever you say it.
Yes, purposefully though. The thing is, I actually did it in time just then.
To any silent watchers of this stream in past, present, or future, I apologize for the butt kicking that will take place today. Why do I get the feeling this is going to be a pathway? Richard, I swear. it's getting annoying now. I really want to know how they arbitrarily decide what gems to put where.
They had board meetings about each and every individual gem.
Jeez. I mean, just the amount in... Is that why Money Bags has so many gems at the end of Spyro 3? It's just a case of... They were like, at the end of Spyro 3, it's like... well, we have some gems left over we need to allocate. Oh, just give them all to Money Bags. What do you mean? Oh, we'll just beat the shit out of Money Bags. Brilliant!
Yeah, that was funny.
How many gems did he have in the last game? 50,000. Ah, 50,000 more gems to the game!
So, I'm doing a Ask meme on Tumblr at the moment, and it's send a heart and you put your muse through a love generator. Both people have gotten 1% on this ask. Gassy loves no one! Fuck you all!
Oh, I need to head bash.
Oh, I see what you need to head bash for. My brothers have been... Hey.
Oh, I need to learn head bash. So, two levels in the autumn place that I need to head bash to complete.
Yep. You would think that you would be able to you think they would teach you the things as you need them.
Yeah.
Not require you to remember that you need to go back to do things.
I wish I could eat
that
these
does stuff. Show more faith in the people, but
I really wish I could eat these berries. That make
what, grow big yourself.
Yeah, just think about it. A giant Spyro running through this game, that would be one of the most threatening things ever.
Yeah, but it's for all of like 5 seconds.
And? That'd be a great power up for a level. Giant Spyro for like 30 seconds maybe.
Suppose. But But then again, I think part of Spyro's fight is a small, young dragon.
If it's a temporary power-up for just one, like, a couple of levels... I mean, a lot of... There's one level in... this game, actually. Where your breath gets changed out for ice breath.
True, and there is one in Year of Dragon.
Oh, it might be New.
And then they just give you different types of breath in Eternal Darkness.
Yeah.
Which, to be fair, that is actually a much better concept. The fact, rather than just, arbitrarily this place or thing, you have a different breath here. It's a case of, okay, you actually do have separate breaths. Which you can really always use and such. What do you think?
Yeah. I still got the fucking Satyr's music in my head. But then again, that's the music I've had in my head. Well, one of the songs I've had in my head for years from Spyro. Just says for his haters. Oh, I keep getting caught by the explosions.
Cool guys don't look at explosions.
But they don't get caught in them either.
They just turn around and walk away.
I've got a question about you, Spyro. If you can eat this ball of what I'm assuming is hot, solidified magma, and you can put that in your mouth and be completely fine, why can't you sit in the magma?
Just because his throat is, and teeth are able to withstand high temperatures due to him being able to breathe fire doesn't necessarily mean his scales can deal with being bathed in it.
Eh, I think he should be able to, he should be fine. At least for a lot longer than he was. I mean, in the first game, it's like, yeah, fair enough, Spyro doesn't know how to swim outright.
Yeah.
But in this one, it's just like...
But isn't it also a case of the moment you touch the water, you are dead, you just drown.
Yeah.
Some chances.
Yeah, pretty much in the first one.
Plus the fact that those rocks possibly aren't as hot as the lava, considering they're solid compared to the liquid around them.
Oh great, now I've got to go on an adventure. Oh, who are you?
Let's go on an adventure, Charlie. Let's go to Candy Mountain, Charlie. I'm surprised you're the one growling at that, Stephen, and not Sarah.
No, I'm not. I wasn't listening to you.
Let's go to Candy Mountain, Sarah.
Ugh.
I wasn't listening to you.
Shire flashbacks.
So, what I was.
Oh, the runny guys holding lamps.
Yes, all of them. Did we really need flashbacks to Spyro 1? Like, at least we'd have to chase one of you down a supercharged road.
What's the flashback to Spyro 1? I think I
missed it. There's one in the first Spyro game, because there's roads, because instead of gates that you travel down to get supercharged, there's a road that you travel down in one of them.
That's in Spyro Year of the Dragon.
No, there's one in the first one as well, because you have to jump across massive gaps and stuff. It's in the Peacecrafters, I think, or Magic Crafters.
Right.
But yeah, it's a brutal world to go through, and and the thing is, the thief can is supercharging as well, obviously. So.
Well, yeah, the road supercharged, so it makes sense. Which always left me a question in Spyro 3, like, I'll turn on the supercharger so you can catch up with this guy who's already running extremely fast. Won't that make him run faster too? What do you think about
I don't know. My thought was always it's a dragon power up. It probably only affects dragons.
Maybe, yeah.
I mean, in the first game, they were running unnaturally fast as well, even without the supercharged bats. Oh, you!
For the longest time, I used to never think about breathing fire when I get close up behind these guys. I would basically just hunt them down until I charge into them. He turned around.
Oh!
Yeah, you gotta make sure you don't get ahead of these guys, or else they decide, I'm going the other way. Why would they run at you?
God damn it!
I think they have a slight tolerance for you being slightly ahead of them, but if you get too far ahead, they will just immediately 180, zoom the other way. Like, these guys must be Olympic sprinters or something. Or, it's very
okay, I'm getting
very
a peacock.
Sprinting. So, I mean, they can turn 180 and not even barely lose any speed.
You know, I think I would have preferred the superchargers.
Fair enough.
Supercharge Highway guy at least was slightly lenient because he was a difficult challenge. This is just... this is why I hate egg thieves. And I don't care, this guy's a lamp thief, they're always gonna be freaking egg thieves to me. I lost sparks, hold on.
Yeah, that one guy you're chasing really seems to be a tough nut to crack.
I mean, he's meant to be the last one you're chasing. I just fell off before I missed the jump to get to the second one. So this guy's actually the last one you're meant to go for.
Fair enough.
But, yeah. If I didn't hit my head randomly on jumps I should make, but the game arbitrarily decides, oh no, you didn't make the jump, I would have this guy by now. What? Wait! What?
What? I'm about to see in a second.
He can turn in midair and go back if you get ahead of him while he's in midair.
Unless he, the moment he landed, he sprung back the other way.
Yeah, but I would have seen him going back. I just turn around, he's suddenly back there, landed already, so he either didn't jump at all and faked me out, or he can change trajectory mid-flight, which is bullshit because I can barely
possibly change trajectory in mid-flight.
Yeah.
Probably because they didn't really think about it too much and just have it as a case of if you're so far that side of him, then he should be coming the other direction.
Damn it! Almost outsmarted him then.
Yeah, you jumped right over his head. Do remember, I think the way you're actually meant to deal with these guys, rather than charging into them, is breathe fire at them.
Yeah, I just did that. The problem is though, you need to get to a certain distance before your fire will even work, because The issue is, if you use fire, you stop sprinting.
Yeah. Well, I saw how you managed that, so I'll do it. Throw the thieves, who's boss? Your own right, boss. Oh. Right, I'll do that quickly. Don't start building explosions.
There we go. Fuck this lamp.
Thanks for bringing back.
Right. There's at least two orbs in this mission, and I can't get one of them. Yeah.
Right.
So I've got to go find the lamp again. Because I'm kind of buggered this time because I didn't recognize where the lamp. Shut up, shorty. Fine, give me the talisman, I don't care.
The simple way to think about it is they tend to head backwards through the level.
Yeah, but that's the thing, it headed backwards, but I didn't recognize. There it is.
Yeah.
Where does this one go? Oh god. These are getting tricky because
they. No way, he just gave you one of the lamps that you just got back.
Yeah. Oh, that's the first tree. Twenty gems is
probably in the thing you need to headbash.
Yeah, in the thing I need to head crash or scale bash or face fuck or whatever the hell they expect me to do with it.
Aye.
It annoys me that I'm leaving a level undone with gems. If it wasn't gems, it was just orbs, I wouldn't mind so much. But it's just the fact that I'm leaving with an odd gem amount. Oh, wait.
Yeah. But back to do with the whole how they decide how many what gems should be where. They probably arbitrarily just decide, let's put a few gems here. And then sort of think, okay, what should they be? Well, we need the total to be this amount, so randomly sort of have them add up to that amount. With weighted values, obviously.
Yeah.
I'd probably do is have something to randomly work out the amount that we need.
Once we get to the end of the game, we can figure out how many gems. Well, there again, we got to subtract all the gems that Moneybags has stolen.
Well done, Spyro.
Come back whenever I'm ready. Because I think. I don't know, but I think there's. Yeah, there's still. This place over here, which I haven't been. So this one's actually hidden beyond hidden, which is odd.
It means you must search beyond the searchable.
Touch the untouchable, break the unbreakable, row row, fight the power. Wait, do I have to?
must find what cannot be found. Break the unbreakable. Stop the unstoppable.
Fuck the unfuckable.
Make cheese toasties out the uncheese toastiable.
Well, I completely made a mince of this, didn't I?
Oh, you're in the speedway. Wait, you got a toast for the Eskimos? But you were helping them earlier. The dragons truly are cruel dictators.
Dragons are evil in this game, like, seriously.
Yeah. How you're messing up these people just peacefully ice skating.
Okay, so there were snowmobiles, archers, skaters, and serpents. Okay. I really shouldn't go to bottom, actually. Just give up and reboot.
Remember, there's generally a certain path which I'm meant to do, because then we generally complete all of one thing and then move on to the next.
Damn it, missed one, missed two. So. Missed one again and. Get back here, there we go.
Yeah, I think you possibly wasted too much time on the snowmobiles. Now you're doing the arches of what's probably backwards.
Oh, that was funny. Just watch. Okay, I'm guessing. That's how you be a badass. Okay, so there's
Curious to see how you're a badass.
Just how I beat that.
Not fair enough. Yeah.
Okay, where the heck is the mission with Hunter this time?
It's not in that lighthouse, is it?
It probably is, but. Yeah, that makes sense, honestly.
Fair enough. Though the delay kind of makes it hard to point out locations and such. But it looks like if what are we gonna head to the lighthouse over on the back? We've only seen one lighthouse. about what happens to the location. But it's not.
I want to go with what my gut says, but I'd have to rip them out to ask. I mean, this little green mountain looked right, but no. It's... Unless that is, like...
I mean, there's a number of things that look right.
Unless there's literally someone in...
But he's not sort of somewhere near the base of the big central building, but, like, close down to the water or something.
That's the way in. Okay, so this one does have an open
hand. Where could it have been?
Oh. Okay.
Okay.
Paragliding.
That was Hunter.
You'll see.
Alright.
Hunter, why do I have to do this? I'm a dragon.
It was the igloo.
Yeah, I didn't think about charging it because I was looking at it, thinking, I'm going to need supercharge for that. And I was like, wait, I naturally have supercharge. What?
Hey, I thought it was just scenery. Oh, well, not sure why you need the shoot. You got wings.
Yeah, it force tapped me out of the game and I lost.
Sucks. I'm about to see what happens as you force, as you tap out there.
Okay, that one was my fault. Okay, now that... Let's do this with... Deep... you're about to see a series of failures like none other.
And soon the series of fails.
Oh.
Hey, I heard you. Yep, there was a fail. Fail number two.
I keep misjudging it because the rings seem to be move. Like, for some reason my brain's like, oh, the rings are moving, but they're not.
It's Hunter that's moving.
Damn it! It's the middle ones that I have problems with because you have to let go of every. It seems like you have to let go of everything.
Yeah.
No, actually, letting go doesn't seem to do anything. Actually, so you have to press get. I don't know.
Have to swing for it at the right time.
Yeah. The This looks I look absolutely ridiculous right now, Hunter, you know that? What the...
Hey, I heard you.
I was so close then. I got through that. That's bullshit, Hunter. There isn't a, hey, I thought you were good at this. No, I was good at it. You're just a fucking idiot. Counted, okay. Not gonna complain.
You've suddenly got a good few hours of footage, should I say.
I wanna do a thing where I do a world a stream. Which means after this, I've still got to beat up Gulp, and then I'll be in Ripto's realm.
Yeah. Maybe they could build a game in 3 streams.
Well, there's the 100% stuff as well after Ripto.
Yeah.
God, this.
What does is the 100% stuff after Ripto? Because obviously you're going to complete most of the world when you get to Ripto.
I can't remember what the 100% is, honestly. Jesus, Hunter, you're killing me.
The truth is, Hunter's trying to buy Ripto time.
Honestly, if that was the case, I wouldn't be surprised at this point.
For the Turtle Revolutionary... The war between the birds and the slimes.
Hey, I heard you.
The enslavement of rock people. How many more things like that there are in this game? The least that I can make it seem, I like that.
Hey, I heard you.
I'm getting so pissed off with you, Hunter. Shut up. Thank you. Yes!
Way to go, Spyro!
Yeah, give me that fucking orb. Yeah, secret challenge. Give up, I'm crashed, yeah, sure, why not?
Oh, it looks like I'm about to watch your winning run. And through the walls.
Well done, Spyro.
Nice.
Shady Oasis and Fracture Hills and go for the comeback floor. I gotta remember how to do.
So now all we have. Yeah, gulps all you got left, isn't it? Awesome Plains.
Nope. We finally made Avalar ours. You've earned the special reward. Now. So, what is it, boy? Oh, the fairy. Here you go. You singed my cape.
You kick his ass.
You are really starting to get on my nerves. Say goodbye, Flame Grim. Go. Lunchtime. Go. Finish him off and you can have all the fairies you can eat. I'm going to enjoy this.
Why did the villains always underestimate me? So, okay, I can't flame him, I can't.
Oh, I recognize this arena.
Wait, do I have to? That's what I do. Okay.
Gulp, swallow! Wait, he has a jetpack? When did that happen?
Yeah.
Yes. No, it's not a jetpack, it's a laser pump, it's on the description.
I don't know how it got his back though.
I want to go back to my dash. Thank you, put me back to my dash.
Hey, this is the problem.
Ah, rockets. Not how many different ordnance you're gonna get dropped.
Nope, I'm gonna kill myself.
Oh, looks like
this is. I remember what was so brutal about Gulp. Now, you don't get any healing items when you're dealing with him.
Mm-hmm. Probably because you need them. Oh, he can. And you blew yourself to Kingdom Come.
Thank you. fuck. Damn it! Yeah, Gulp's probably the hardest boss in this game for me, honestly.
How about Robo Gulp?
Robo Gulp's easy compared to that, because you actually get given. I keep doing that. There has to be a better way.
Putting explosives in his face and then getting blown up by him.
Yeah.
Speaking, you've been streaming since what, like 4 o'clock or something?
Yeah. So I've been going for quite a while.
Yeah, it's just nice. That's 5 hours. Not continuous, but. Can't say that you don't give content.
Yeah. It's kind of funny because that we're talking about Terraria and Terra saying that she wasn't going to be on here, and yet the only one who's not here is Kieran.
Kieran's already doing something today. I already said earlier, sometimes people tell me to do something because it's bank holiday. As far as we're aware, that's the only time he's done. I'm pretty sure you ignited the thing he ate.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I did as well. Damn it. Okay, this is a hell of a lot of health to go through.
Yeah. At least you can actually see though. You need to hit him this many more times. I wonder if you could grab that, if you could have grabbed that other rocket before the
You might be able to, but it's very hard.
I had to grab a rocket, and then to kick, grab a rocket, kick the barrel, and see if you can then launch the rocket into it afterwards. But that would have been too late.
No, it wouldn't let me grab that rocket, so no.
So you can't launch the rocket and grab another rocket? Well, I wonder if you could have one already grabbed.
Also, do you know you were talking about these birds earlier and how they're like throwing up bombs and stuff?
These ones are laying bombs.
That was bullshit, and you know it, game. fucking game killed me. Like, arbitrarily at its last health point.
Let's see what happened. Okay, so hit me once. Hit me twice. Wow, that was some terrible luck. Hey, I got cupcakes. No? Okay.
Hey, David. What? I brought cake.
I just thought some bullshit on your side. There's no way that barrel hit gold.
Honestly, I don't give a shit. Gulp's bullshitted me enough, I get to bullshit back.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a bit silly of me, but oh well. Stopped him from doing a wide range attack, so. Got him!
Nice.
I had no health left either.
Yeah, you're coming down to green. You know how was a gold piece in this one? And there's the victory. Finally starting to get along. Since you've done so much for Avalar, and since I know you really miss being on vacation, we really wanted to do something nice for you. It's not much, but we hope you like it.
Wow, this is great. Aren't you gonna join me?
No. I'd like to, but I've gotta go check on the professor in the winter tundra. He's still trying to fix the super portal so we can send you home.
Oh.
That sounds interesting.
I think I'll just hang out here for a while and soak up a few rays. Hey, where'd Alora go? I better follow her.
I think I've finally come up with a way to access the Dragon Worlds from the Super Portal. This power crystal should give us the extra boost that we need. Just a few more calculations to set it up. I think I have it. Excellent! Everything is finally ready. We're going to need a lot more orbs, but with the power crystal boosting it, the super portal should work again.
So, you thought you...
They're all traitors.
Well, I'm afraid not. I persuaded that fat bear Moneybags to sell me a few bombs.
Quick, the power crystal!
Don't even try it, book boy, or you'll be the world's smartest pile of ashen.
Aha! No.
This is just what I need for a new scepter.
Hunter, do something quick!
Hey, give that back! Well, I tried.
You little fools! After I destroy you all with my new scepter, I'm going to rename this place Riptonia!
That's one of the most satisfying things to watch.
Yeah, Hunter is so a traitor in that.
Yeah.
He made no effort to get it back. Money fights getting the last kick out of the castle.
Yeah, it's always satisfying to watch that.
Fair enough.
Penguin, get over here. There we go, now I can be lazy again. Just collect all the gems in this place.
Yeah. I can always see how you meant to destroy those boulders.
Yeah.
The money bags. And have him teach you how to smash rocks with your face. Looks like you haven't already known how to smash things with your face already.
I'm actually wondering how many wolves there are. I thought there was 100, but there might just be like 90 or something, or 80, or 60.
And how many have you gone so far?
45.
There's probably something like 60. There might be 100.
Yeah, there might be one wild with just too many of them. A thousand. There's an orb.
In Year of the Dragon, I would often go around killing tons of the little health minions to just basically get a bunch of lives.
Yeah.
I remember Midday Gardens being a good one for that. So many rabbits.
This I have to
all from broken all.
Yeah, there is one thing that the Spyro series has learnt from with its mistakes.
What's that?
They don't make a put for like hazards like lava in the home worlds in this one.
They
do in the first one.
They do in the third one, at least in Midnight Mountain.
But then again, I guess
I specifically remember that it's quite easy to fall off the edge there.
No, I mean, I just mean like lava. Like lava hazards, like, yeah. Just drowning.
As I was saying, you can fall off the edge as well as at least around one of the portals there's lava.
Is that all the rocks? Let's go back to Autumn Plains. I've got to go back to 2 damn levels because the game couldn't just let me have progression.
Yeah. Awkward progression is awkward.
Okay, what levels were they? Fracture Hills and Shady Oasis.
Yes, that sounds about right. But I assume you just looked in the guide, but...
Yeah. Oh, wait.
You know what would be a really dick move?
What?
To go between the worlds, costed, orbs, until you complete the game.
Yeah.
Or until you defeat Ripto.
Although, honestly, I don't know. That, because the thing is, you need to have certain amounts of orbs to get unlocked levels, so that would be kind of really evil.
Exactly.
Scorch. Fracture Hills. Oh, great. Do I have to... Okay, good. I can skip you guys. I have to release all the satyrs again. Like, that's what I have to do because... the end of the level is locked behind satyrs.
Yeah.
It's no wonder this song was in my head. It fits out. I to do that.
Yeah, really, there's no wonder that you've got that song stuck in your head. So this is just a simple tune.
I'm also understanding why the freaking rock people don't like this music. It's great to be...
yeah, because it's not rock. They prefer a good bit of Freddy. I'm sure you'd also rather a good bit of Freddy as well.
Yeah. Well, I don't know how he played the electric guitar with those claws.
Well, here's the queen.
You didn't get my joke at all.
Pretty crude.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah, I got it.
I gotta remember where the hell Hunter is.
Hunter was somewhere nearest the start of the charge path because of his feet being trapped in the rocks.
Yeah.
And all the doors have returned as well.
Okay, where am I going?
You know, when you think about it, some of these walls are really small. They really have crammed a lot into a small amount of space.
Yeah. I mean, that was the thing about Spyro 2 compared to Spyro 1. It was bigger and smaller at the same time.
Yeah.
It was bigger because there was more levels, but it was smaller because all the levels were smaller. And I mean, the overworld, the home worlds in the first game were actual, like, adventures in themselves.
Yeah.
Oh. Really? Oh, you're fucking kidding me.
Granted, in the first game, Spyro also had a little bit of an annoying attitude. At least in this game, he's got a little bit of attitude. Oh, I just saw you run past where Hunter was.
Yep, you realize what I'm really mad at now.
Yeah. That is one of the bad things about these old games. They can't save as much between loading the levels. Like, it seems to remember to be able to save that you've got all the gems and stuff, but nothing more really, can they?
Yeah, this one was really simple. Has this cast got this orb? Yeah, if yes.
Yeah.
Oh, you idiot! You didn't have to turn around. I'll escort you up someone's ass in a minute, Alchemist. You're really fucking annoying me with your walking path.
Yeah, their walking paths are so much deeper. To keep you on your toes to make sure you're paying attention. One thing you could in theory do is possibly kick all those guys to sort of one corner well out of the way.
I get the feeling.
It'll work, but
yeah, I get the feeling it would reset them if I did that. Anyway, I've got to go find some pigs because for some reason this game arbitrarily decides to fuck me over.
Granted, is there any lava you can kick them into?
Nope. No way to get rid of. Until Hunter's mission, you can't get rid of them. Just look after this orb I've already given you. Thank you, Zoe, for zapping me for no reason. As long as you're here.
I'm killing brain cells. See, managed to free Hunter.
Hunter, you've got to have some rhyme or reason for your bloody shooting. You can't just shoot these guys randomly.
Is there really a problem with him getting back up again? I suppose they have to add some level of challenge.
No! No! Fuck off of that one. As long as you're here. Have you ever felt like a mission was padding? Like they needed one more orb in the game, but they couldn't figure it out, so they just made some stupid, pointless mission.
I hope so.
Because this is what it feels like to me. No! Okay, this game's bullshitting me now. I got stuck on an Earth Shaper. I couldn't move. So basically, it forced me to lose on the next one because I couldn't get to him in time because I was stuck on the first one.
Yeah, I just saw you getting stuck and all that.
Okay, good, I can. If they add a penalty for that, I'm gonna frickin' murder them. Okay, good. Now I need to kill enemies in this one because I need to charge the super gates. Shut up, you have an apple. Just go forward, you fucking hippo.
One more world for this.
Yep, this will be the last thing I do on the stream is this.
I found the leaderboard for the speedruns of Spyro 2.
Yeah.
The quickest time that someone has completed Spyro 2 is just under 9 hours.
Wait, really?
Second is also.
Is that 100%? Or any percent?
I mean, if it's any percent, then, or if it's 100%, then I actually stand a good chance of beating that record.
It's, both of things is simply from the start of a game to completing, basically from the start to defeating Rector.
Ah, you need a certain level of completionism for Rector anyway, so.
And I would say you're certainly quite a bit behind. I mean, in theory, you'd be on the leaderboard, possibly, because the leaderboard currently goes to 53rd. Wait, no. Sorry, not 8 hours.
Eight minutes 50. I was going to say, I'm just looking at the leaderboard for the Any% and we're at 8 minutes 50.
How?
Any% percent.
Yeah, but 8 minutes, but how?
Back in a sec.
They must have glitched the game.
All skips and glitches are allowed as long as you defeat Ripto. Fast disk speed for PS2, allowed for all regions.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay,
if it's, and if
the 100% run, the 100% one is just under 2 hours.
Yeah, I'm nowhere near that then.
Yeah.
Let's get back.
65th on the leaderboard is on the 100% complete is 5 hours 17 minutes and 2 seconds.
I'm basically going to go up and see how many orbs I need to get to Ripto. It could be that I'm allowed to actually access his level right now.
Well, I know you probably need the talismans.
I didn't know that I needed talismans, just orbs this time.
Interesting.
Okay, unless... Yep, I can actually go fight Ripto and complete the game right now.
Well, you gonna finish the stream off with that, or are you just gonna finish the stream off?
I'm gonna just finish the stream off because I want to get 100% of all the stuff in the game. It's not the fastest run through the game, sure, but it's been the most frustrating.
I don't know, I bet some of those speedrunners had some pretty frustrating moments.
Yeah, mine's less frustrations with some of the game mechanics, and more frustration with Hunter. Hunter is a bloody dick. I can see
you, Blur. But then if you're doing a 100% speedrun, they're probably going to have all the annoyances that you've had.
Compressed into a 10-minute space.
While I'm here, I'm gonna go see what the 100% speed.
1 hour 41.
41.9. Not bad.
There's no way I've beaten that, but oh well.
Considering you've been streaming the second one for about 5 hours today, no. 5.5 hours.
Yeah, but speedrunning requires knowing the game and practicing routes for fucking months on end.
Yeah.
Unless you're doing Pokemon Red or Blue's speedrun. Any percent speedrun.
In which case, it's just the quickest you can glitch to the.
It really is. The fastest you can glitch warp, and I think it's now optimized and no one else can beat it.
Yeah. Unless a better way is found.
It's the only one you can do it. Glitch it over.
Okay, so I'm missing one orb still.
I'm now going to go watch this Rift Spiral 2 thing while I'm eating.
Okay, so where's... Oh, wait, I remember.
You know I told you, John, not to go into Misty Underleveled?
Yeah.
I did Misty Underleveled and I've just done Surge Underleveled and I'm going, I need to stop for this.
Stop!
I know this game well enough that I can go, actually I can risk it. That and I had Nidoking and Surge's Ace cannot touch Nidoking, it's glorious.
I just completely went to Tundra.
It only knows electric type moves, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, that... I think one of my favourite things to do, it's very hard to do it, but my favourite thing
is... Go fetch the Pidgey and go beat up Giovanni?
Yeah, take a level 2 Pidgey to Giovanni's Dug Trio.
Can't you do it to his entire team?
I think some of his team have coverage, but his Dug Trio is definitely one that you can just go meh.
I think his Dug Trio is the only one that you can go meh on, but anyway, that's... I've got to stop there, because... Been streaming for much longer than I ever thought I would be today, so thank you.
It's been fun.
Yeah, it's been fun. Thank you for watching, and hopefully the next time I stream, if it's not Saturday at least, I will be doing Winter Tundra. Maybe all of it. So until then, thanks for watching and goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye.